About once a year, we get a visit from a car-sized asteroid. Not impressive enough for a movie plot, but it makes a cool fireball as it enters the Earth's atmosphere. It burns up before it reaches the surface of the Earth. About every few thousand years, we get hit by asteroids the size of a football field, and they can cause major damage. So a group of scientists at NASA's Planetary Defense Coordination Office keep track of as many of those near-Earth objects, and today they started a mission that could help us avoid a cataclysmic scenario. The mission is called the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART. Early this morning, they launched a spacecraft. That spacecraft is going to be on a 10-month journey toward a binary asteroid, which is basically two asteroids which orbit a common center, 6 million miles away from Earth, where luckily they pose no danger to us. Now, if all goes according to plan, the spacecraft will crash into the smaller of the two asteroids at 15,000 miles per hour, giving it enough of a nudge to kick it off course and to change its speed. Now, right before impact, the spacecraft will release a tiny satellite, there you go, that's going to take pictures of the collision and its space debris and then send the pictures back to Earth. The NASA scientists will also use telescopes to observe how much the impact changed the asteroid's trajectory in space. The point here is to add this method, this diversion method, to their strategy to keep asteroids out of Earth's orbit. To quote NASA's Planetary Defense Officer Lindley Johnson, the right time to deflect an asteroid is as far away from the Earth as we can. All right, who better to talk to this than Bill Nye, CEO of the Planetary Society, also known as the Science Guy. Bill, great to see you tonight in an area of deep expertise for you. Let's talk about this. What is this? What is the aim here, that we're going to deflect asteroids headed for Earth so that they miss us?
Yeah, so everybody, just when I was a kid, nobody had a good hypothesis as to what happened to the ancient dinosaurs. But now we do, the last 30 years or so, everybody 40 years, people realize it was almost certainly an asteroid impact that finished them off. And there have been several other enormous asteroid impacts here on Earth that would be catastrophic. So someday, in non-science fiction fashion, we're going to have to deflect one. So this Didymos binary asteroid, Didymos A and B, or Didymos and Dimorphos, if you're into happy naming, is an asteroid where you have an asteroid that has a wide center, like this double strawberry, and then you have another asteroid going around it, like the blueberry. So if you can hit the blueberry with a spacecraft, like these strawberry leaves, then you can slow this smaller asteroid down ever so slightly, ever so slightly. And then when an object is closer to the larger, when a smaller object is closer to the larger object, it will go around faster. That's why, if, for example, Mercury goes around the sun much faster than our Earth does. And so we'll be able to detect this tiny change in the period of the smaller asteroid. And this will prove or disprove the hypothesis that this so-called kinetic impact, energy impact, could deflect an asteroid in the future and, dare I say it, save the world.
Well, we, you know, you and I are of an era where we had some great science fiction shows and books, and in those, they would have just blasted any asteroid that threatened Earth to smithereens. We apparently don't have that technology.
No. Plus, there's a few problems with that. You'd have to get a large, let's say, nuclear weapon on top of a rocket and shoot it into space. All your allies and adversaries would have to trust you doing that. And then it would have to work. That the idea would be to get near enough to an asteroid, set off an explosion. The heat would volatilize, vaporize, ablate, burn off some of the asteroid, and that momentum of the pushed off stuff would push the asteroid. That may work, but even simpler and more straightforward is just hitting the asteroid with something very small, but going very, very fast. DART, double asteroid redirection test, is going about, it's going about 4 miles a second. 4 miles a second.
Wow.
So it has a lot of momentum. And so when we hit this smaller asteroid, we are very hopeful that it'll give it a nudge. Now, the composition of the asteroids is not exactly known. So they're so-called XK asteroids. So we're hoping, or we're confident, that when we hit it with this DART spacecraft, it'll hit it and give it a push rather than just kind of go right through it like a sieve full of gravel or something. So everybody, this is a very inexpensive test of what may one day be a planet-saving technology.
Yes, it'll seem like a great value when it actually saves us from something. I don't know if it's a first, Bill. It's always good to see you, but this might be the first time on The Rachel Maddow Show that we've had a live strawberry and a blueberry. I'll check if that's true. Always good to see you, my friend. Bill Nye is the CEO of the Planetary Society. We appreciate your time tonight.